ஸ்ரீமான் வெங்கடநாதாரிய கவிதார்க்கிகேசரி வேதாந்தாச்சாரவரியோ மே சந்நிதத்தாம் சதாகிருதி நமோ நாராயணா. இந்த ஸ்லோகம் 11 ஆழ்வார் மென்ஷன்ட், அண்ட் டு த மைண்ட் விச் வாஸ் குவைட் ஸ்கேர்ட் அண்ட் ஷிவரிங் டியூ டு த பாபம்ஸ் தட் த ஜீவாத்மா ஹேட் கமிட்டட் இன் த பாஸ்ட். So, Mabhir Mandamanaha, O foolish mind, do not worry. Dhyayasva Narayanam, meditate on Narayana. And he, Swami Alvar, consoled the mind in the 11th verse. And in the 12th verse, Alvar said, Bhava Jalati Kathana. In that slokam, he talked about the cruelty and the wildness of Samsara Sagaram, and he mentioned that there is no other savior other than Vishnu. The boat called Vishnu would facilitate us to cross the samsaric ocean and reach us safely at the shores. Alvar again assured the mind. Now, in assuming, consider that we are caught by the tiger in the forest, and we are already caught by the tiger, and there is somebody who is there at 5 feet with a gun to kill the tiger, and he is going to pull the trigger. And at that time, when we know that that person is going to pull the trigger and going to kill the tiger, still that we are still shivering with fear, having pain, bleeding, and worried whether it would happen and all that. So how am I going to get rid of this danger? Am I going to be killed by the tiger? All that would still be there regardless of the proximity of the savior in the nearest distance. With the right tools, still, even though there is Vishnu Podam, the boat called Vishnu, because the samsaram, how will I be able to cross the ocean of samsara sagaram? And the mind is still afraid and scared. So that's the avatarikai, and Swami Alvar mentions again that the semblance or the Bhagavad Bhakti that you have is enough, and that would facilitate you to get saved. Do not lament, do not fear. And that's what he gives, ashwasanam, assurance, consolation to the mind. 13th verse, Bhava Jaladim Agadam Dustaram Nistareyam கதமகமிதி சேதோ மஸ்மகா காதரத்வம் சரசிஜதிருஷி தேவே தாவகி பக்திரேகா நரகபீதி நிஷண்ணா தாரயிஷ்யத்யவசியம் சரசிஜதிருஷி தேவே தாவகி பக்திரேகா. தெர் இஸ் ஆல்சோ அனதர் வர்ஷன் இன் த வர்ஸ் தட் சரசிஜதிருஷி தேவே Tavaki Bhakti Resha. Bhakti Resha instead of Bhakti Rekha is also another patam. Here, Kulasekara Alvar assures and consoles and comforts his mind and assures that there is no need to be afraid of. There is no need to fear about crossing the dangerous, deep, samsaric ocean. With the disqualification or with the lack of abilities that we have. And he says that the bhakti for the Santamarai Kannan, the red lotus eyed lord, the Vishnu, and that is enough to cross. That would transport us to the shore completely, and we will be away from the dangerous waters of the samsaram. And that's what he says here. Bhava jaladim agadam. He chetaha, O mind. Agadam, deep. Dustaram, swayatnam, our own effort to cross. Bhava jaladim, samsara sagaram. Aham, I. Katam, how? Nistareyam, jump, cross. How will I be able to cross the deep, vast ocean, and which is not possible by us, the samsara sagaram? How will I be able to? O mind, iti kataratvam basmakaha. Like that, do not be afraid of. Basmakaha means adayavendam. Do not. Kataratvam, bayandirupade. Be afraid of, do not be afraid of this. Which one? That, how am I able to cross the samsari question which is deep? Do not worry about it. Naraka, sarasija drishi deve tavaki bhakti reka. Sarasija drishi, tamarei vatta trikkangalai udayavan. He is a red lotus eyed lord. He is Pundarikakshan. He has got the beauty of the eyes which is majestic, divine. Long, large, well laid out, spread out, ruddy lined, vatsalyam. And in that eyes, because of vatsalyam looking at us, it is so reddish in color that the moment one sees the beauty of the Lord, that eyes of the Lord, that itself is adequate for us to fall flat in love. Adoration, bhakti, that that alone is enough. And he is Narakabhiti. Narakabhiti means the one who killed Narakasuran, the one who destroys Narakam. Narakabhiti for us. So two meanings. One is he kills Narakasuran. He is the one, he is Naraka Nivartakan, the one who get us rid of Naraka Vasam. And Anishta Nivartakatvam Vivakshitam. In this Narakabhiti, Anishtam, the Narakam, the hell, scorches, get extinguished because of him, because of Krishna. And he is not only Narakanivartakam, he is also beautiful. Look at his eyes. Can the Devatantarams, Chaturmukha Brahma, Rudran, they don't have Narakanivartakam, nor are they so beautiful like this, with Vatsalyam, Saundaryam, Lavanyam. And do they have both? The kshiram, milk, is pittadi nivartakam as well as bhogyam. The milk removes the pittam as well as it is bhogyam, parama bhogyam. The medicine which is sweet as well as gets rid of the disease. Like that, Perumal is so beautiful to look at. Subham, shubham as well as ashrayam. It is so nice as well as bhogyam. So bhogyam and medicinal value. So nishanna stiti, this patri irikkira narakabhiti nishanna tara ishyatyavashyam. Nishanna, to hold on to. Tavaki, your bhakti yeka, that bhakti alone, avashyam, certainly tara ishyati, will make you will make you cross, will facilitate you to cross the ocean of samsara. Here tavaki bhakti resha means the bhakti, your bhakti yesha means the little atyalpam, the little bit of bhakti, semblance of bhakti alone, avashyam tarayishyati, certainly will facilitate you to cross. Hence, do not lament, do not fear. Svalpamapyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bayat. In Bhagavad Gita 2.40, there is a slokam which says, Neha bikra manashosti pratyavayo navidyate. Svalpamapyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bayat. In this karma yoga which you have begun, There is no destruction for the Karma Yoga. And once you start or begin, even if you stop in between, there is no dosham. And this Karma Yoga, even a little bit of semblance of this Karma Yoga will protect you from samsara bhayam. Krishna says, Swalpam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. Little bit, semblance of this dharma will facilitate you to get rid of the fear of samsara. When such is the case, Bhagavad Bhakti, Bhagavad Bhakti Resham, even alpam, little bit of Bhagavad Bhakti. You may say, I do not have so much Bhagavad Bhakti. Even then, do not worry. You may say, for I have very little. Ippodirikkira atyalpa bhaktiyum avashyam taranam pandivikum. Definitely, even the little bit of semblance of iota of bhakti that you have, with this kaimutika nyayam, which is from this Bhagavad Gita slokam, that bhaktiyale sarveshwaran will be able to samsara samudra taranam, will be able to facilitate you to cross the ocean of samsara. That's the meaning here. Avashya. And deva, sarasija drishi deve, this deva, deva shabdam, though it refers to Brahma, Rudrati, Indras, all this, everybody is called Devan these days. And Pundarikakshatvam, there is nobody. Because that is why Sarasija Drishi Deve Tavaki Bhakti Reka. But that Pundarikaksham is not possible for others. That Pundarikaksham, Sentamarai Kannan, that I alone is enough for us to develop bhakti. Once you look at his eyes, there will be a semblance of bhakti that would sprout in your heart. That bhakti alone would facilitate you to cross the ocean, says Alvar here. So, O mind, the Narakantakan, Pundarikaksham, Sri Krishnan, on him you have asanchala bhakti, that alone would certainly, surely will facilitate you to cross the samsara sagaram. Karegana vannadadum tan yatnattal taandamudiyadadumana samsara kadalai alpa shaktiyum illadanan eppadi taanda pogiren endru bayappada vendam. There is no way that the deep ocean, vast ocean, I am not able to even see the shore on the other side. How am I able to cross with my own effort? And I do not have any shakti, alpa shakti also I don't have. Do not fear about that. He is there with an iota of bhakti on him. He can facilitate you to cross the ocean. He addresses the mind and gives an assuaging assurance to the mind not to worry, and consoles. That is for us to not to get worried. Alvar addresses us through his mind. Alvar Emperumanar Desigan Trivadigale Sharanam Kavitarkika Simmaya Kalyana Gunashaline Srimate Venkateshaya Vedanta Gurave Namaha Sarvam Sri Krishna Arpanamastu Namo Narayana Dasa.